fundamental rights?
So fundamental rights are basic rights that are given by the Constitution of India to the citizens of our country. And the difference between fundamental right and a legal right is that, so they are protected by the Supreme Court and High Court of our country. Whenever a citizen is aggrieved, they can directly go to Supreme Court for the remedy.
So these are inalienable?
No, so they are not inalienable rights. There are certain conditions which are mentioned in the Constitution itself.
You are right. Article 21.
Yes, sir.
What are the conditions under which Article 21, right to life and personal liberty, can be taken away?
So to maintain security and sovereignty, integrity of India, public order, health, morality, and
are these the grounds for taking away Article 21?
Article 20 and 21 per se cannot be taken by when national emergencies.
What you said was these are the grounds under Article 19(2).
So they cannot be taken away. These are the grounds that specify.
Restricted.
That is not absolute right. That's what I'm.
Okay. What are the how Article 21 can be restricted?
Sir, when national emergencies are placed under Article 352, Article 20 and 21 cannot be taken away. They are in any circumstances, but Article 19.
You are not getting the question. Is Article 21 absolute?
Sir, Article 21 is not absolute.
So, what are the limitations to it?
The conditions I earlier mentioned, the sovereignty and security.
What is preventive detention?
Okay, so preventive detention is when anybody is arrested by the police before the commitment of crime. And the crime has not actually happened, but it is in the minds of the state or the police that a certain person, they are liable to commit because of some past offences they have done.
Okay, and what is due process of law?
So due process of law means that the law itself must be fair. And it is not that like the procedure established by law, whatever is given in the law, we are bound by that only. But the due process of law maintains that law itself must be fair and just.
So when we talk of due process of law, primarily which article of the Constitution we are referring to?
So in the 21 article, sir.
So it can be taken away by due process of law. Which was the case?
Which established due process of law. Sir, Manika Gandhi case versus Union of India. In this, Supreme Court established.
Okay, yeah, right. What is judicial review?
So judicial review is whenever executive or legislature passes or takes any step, then the matter can go before court, and court may analyze it on the basis of constitutionality, and it may render it ultra vires of the constitution on the basis if it.
And what is judicial activity?
So judicial activism, when a judiciary steps into the domain of executive or legislature to perform their task, which is primarily the task of legislature or executive, but when judiciary itself steps into that domain. So for example, the cleaning of Taj Mahal was.
Okay. Can you, Taj Mahal, do you know what is TTZ?
It's a TTZ.
Taj Trapezium Zone. Okay. Can you tell us about some of the salient features of right to education?
So, salient features of Right to Education Act, sir, first of all, every student in the age of 6 to 14 must get free and compulsory education by the state. And sir, apart from that, in private education institutions, 25% of the seats must be reserved for underprivileged sections of society. And sir, it also provides for the toilet facilities for students, for girl children especially. And sir, in every in particular distance of every hamlet or village.
Okay, you're right. Why was adultery? It was an offence in
the Indian Penal Code.
It has been decriminalized. Why?
So, because Supreme Court realized that as per adultery law, a man can take into the in a police station maybe because he the other man had relations with his wife. So, sir, that Supreme Court realized that this law makes women as per the property of men. And female cannot let her husband be convicted if he is involved in adultery. So it was against the right of equality also.
Wife cannot file a case.
Yes, wife cannot file a case against her husband.
Husband's, okay. Thank
yes,
you.
It was right.
Bhawna.
Yes.
You take interest in badminton?
Yes, sir.
Do you play badminton?
So sometimes, during my school days and my college and during my company also used to play this a lot. So since I've been preparing for civil services, a habit has been a little broken.
Civil service takes you away from your
it demands quite a lot of dedication, sir. Rather than playing badminton, I've been involved in like walking and normal
pranayama. Good. Name some prominent badminton players of India, both girl and men and women.
So, women, Jwala Gupta and Sir Saina Nehwal are prominent players from India. And
some other.
Sir, B.B. Sindhu. Sir, Prakash Padukone.
Again, you are going to 1980s.
Yes, he is. It's because he got the highest badminton player award from India. He had been ranked one, sir, in the world. So
but nowadays also, you have been.
Yes, sir, actually. Pamela Gopichand is also.
Gopichand?
Yes.
And then?
Sir, apart from that, I'm not able to remember.
Not following that?
Yes, sir.
Are you reading newspapers?
Yes, sir.
Regularly?
Yes, sir.
Okay. This PV Sindhu has got some contract?
Sir, recently though, there was Indonesian finals game.
There is a contract.
Contract? So regarding advertisement. Yes, she has got many contracts.
No, just recently. So 50 crore from a Chinese partner. You see, I just wanted to test whether you are reading newspaper that thoroughly or not. And because you are a badminton lover. Okay. Delhi pollution.
Yes, sir.
What are the causes of pollution of air pollution in Delhi?
So the major cause is the air vehicular emissions. So apart from that, construction dust. There are many garbage dumps which we can see at so many places in Delhi. They are burnt right away. Mm-hmm. So apart from that, the rice stalks which are burnt in Punjab and Haryana after the harvesting season. So the geography of Delhi is such that these emissions come from those states to Delhi, and due to low air pressure, it get intensified over here, and it just does not move and appears as the members move.
Okay. Geography is your optional,
yes,
isn't it?
Yes.
What was the need for this second green revolution, this evergreen revolution? We had a green revolution.
Yes, sir.
We attained also self-sufficiency in food grains.
Yes, sir.
So, what was the need for the second?
So, first green revolution was primarily active in Punjab, Haryana and Western Uttar Pradesh and some parts of Andhra Pradesh also. So, sir, many parts of India did not gain much from it and they still live in poverty. And so, Punjab and Haryana gained very much and the per capita income of these areas is very good. So, having the opportunity...
That is one of the reasons.
Yes, so that is one of the reasons. Sir, apart from that, sir, this has in organic farming also... So, because the overuse of pesticides and fertilizers tend to make food unhealthy for the consumption, and the second revolution has such tendency to go towards organic farming and some more sustainable agriculture. Sir.
Because of salinity of the soil in Punjab,
yes, sir,
and other things.
Yes, sir,
that aspect also you have to say. What else?
So groundwater levels are also declining, so for water consumption also, and population, to feed the growing population of the country, lot more options.
It covers more crops.
Yes, sir.
Horticulture,
fruits
also.
And vegetables, sir. That was
pulses.
Going to say next. Yes,
so you have to, because you are a geography student, so
yes,
you have to all of demographic dividend.
So
what is demographic dividend? First define.
Okay. So, demographic dividend means taking the population of the country is, we have a young cohort, sir. India is a young country in sense that nearly 40% of the population comes into young cohort. And, sir, taking advantage of them in the economic growth or development of the country is...
If you are a geography student, it has a particular definition. Why it is called dividend? Not young cohort. But, you know, you don't go by this jugglery of words.
Yes, sir.
In geography, there is a terminology for this. Working age group.
Sir, exactly. Working age group. Sir.
So, what does it say?
So, it says that the working age group must be having human capital so as to contribute in economic development of the country in a positive way, sir.
No.
And they do not become a burden on the nation?
It is like this. The working age group population in India, 15 to 59, you have to answer this, yeah? Is how much? 60%.
Yes,
more than 60%.
Yes,
so the dependency level is less. The less people in the above 60.
Yes.
So the dependency is less. That is why they say dividend to the nation.
Yes, sir.
But how some critics say that it is not a real dividend? Why it is said so?
So it is said so because, sir, there are many problems. There is problem of skill development and optimum education, optimum job opportunities also. And so due to the mismatch in skills and the job opportunities offered in our nation. So we are
that
not able
to. You mean to say that means there is lot of jobs, but because skills are not there, we are unemployed.
So yes, there are certain jobs in industry sector. Yes, sir.
Because
but
of skills, they
skills
are
not available. Yes,
what?
Sir.
You mean to say there are enough jobs?
So no.
What is the unemployment?
So recently the unemployment survey came from National Statistical Commission. It has said that unemployment rate is at the highest in like last 45 years. It is at 6%. So yes.
Otherwise also, Matam, you know how many young population entering into job market every month or every year? You have any idea?
Million.
1 million every month. 12 million a year.
Yes.
Okay. So they are not getting job and there is not skill.
Yes.
So because of lack of this is going to be a demographic disaster, some critics say.
Yes, sir.
What are the way out?
So first of all is skill programs which is currently happening in our government only. Skill programs should be industry oriented. So first of all is this. The second is basic education in school level. So recently ASR survey also came out. It says that even basic education level of children is not up to mark. So investments need to be done in that sector also. And sir, apart from that,
job opportunities.
So job opportunities need to be created, exactly.
Okay, thank you.
We have information technology as a subject in BTEC.
Yes.
And geography is optional.
Yes.
And after some IT related questions, what is this digital wildfire?
Digital wildfire?
Yeah. Have you heard about it?
Yes.
What about this fake news?
So fake news is sir, any news that is widely circulated on social media. It tends to be a rumor, but sir, it spreads at so fast rate due to the speed of and availability of social media.
That is digital warfare.
Okay, sir.
Misinformation, fake news, these are the problems. Okay. Now IT. There are various IT products, smartphones and all these out there. What do you think is the major problem now as far as the society is concerned, not the economic, but the society is concerned? Now this, tell me two problems which has really emerged of late in the IT sector. Because
so
of this.
Regarding social,
social media. Yeah. Like I said, social media. It also bringing out the fake news, misinformation.
So, but on societal level, what are its damages?
Yeah.
So, first of all, it brings high individualism in society. So, people are, families are kind of getting apart from each other. People are spending more and more time on their cell phones. Even so, children of younger age, they spend hours playing. And so, Facebook, so this is second point. So, more and more people are getting into show-off kind of life, sir. They are not actually involved in some affairs, but so this also creates pressure on our society and it has become a major cause of stress and depression among the young populations. So these are two problems that is social media is
having. Very good. Now moving on, there is digital payments. Now, how do you define digital payments?
So digital payment is a payment which takes through online platform. It is not actual money transfer but e-payment basically.
No,
electronic mode is.
No, it is defined under which act or which rule or law.
Okay, so this is financial systems law by RBI. I'm not exactly, but there is financial settlements, payment settlements law or something like that, sir.
Payment settlement act.
Yes, payment settlements act.
So the regulator is RBI.
Yes, sir.
Right. Now somebody has unauthorizedly taken away some money from your account,
yes,
right? So how, what is the redressal available to you now today?
So RBI has recently circulated that whenever money gets out from my account due to any unfair means, I need to tell my bank about it, inform them, and the bank has been mandated by RBI to take the accurate steps within a timeline. If the money has gone out of my account and I was not involved in it at all, then it is the responsibility of the bank itself to take proper steps and redress.
What timeline you have to?
So for 3 days, I think. So.
3 days and 7 days.
Yes. So 3 days for me to inform bank and 7 days for
20 lakh or something. Okay, any other regulation which RBI has brought in for safe digital payments?
For safe, so regarding RBI steps, I am not aware. But
ombudsman, the stated reports of ombudsman. Even if there is a, you know, the dispute between the bank and you, they will decide this. This is essentially. Okay, now moving on again to geography. How many coastal states we have?
Should I just name them because I...
No, they are the same number. 8, 4, 5, 6.
No, so they are not more than that.
20, 15.
No, so they are more than 10, I guess. So,
nine.
Okay, nine.
Now, what is the contribution of these coastal states to country's GDP vis-a-vis the contribution to population?
Okay, so these coastal states, so I have to tell about their contribution regarding in comparison to others.
Then India's GDP is X. India has how many states?
28.
I'm sorry,
I'm really feeling nervous right now. So.
Okay, okay.
Don't it's a very basic question. I'm
29. India has X number of states. Yes, out of that, 9 are coastal states.
Yes,
so these 9 coastal states contribute to India's GDP some amount. And also the population.
Yes, so their contribution to GDP is much higher as comparison to their population. So because they serve as a major center for trade, and so states like Maharashtra, they contribute very much. Tamil Nadu, due to major ports like Chennai, Kolkata, and Mumbai also, even Gujarat. So their contribution to GDP is very high in regarding to their. With respect to their population, because population mainly is in North India, so in states like in Uttar Pradesh and Bihar, they are highly populated areas. So their contribution is somewhat greater than that.
So 9 states contributing so heavily to GDP, the rest Punjab, Haryana, they don't contribute.
Sir, Punjab and Haryana, they also contribute, sir, but Punjab is majorly involved in agriculture, sir. And Haryana has Gurugram, which is a major contributor to its GDP, sir.
Okay. Fine. Last question. In electronics, are we a net importer or exporter?
Sir, we are net importer.
What can you do? What strategy should you advocate for making it a net exporter?
Sir, actually, when I was in my college, I also noticed that the research options in colleges are missing, and the kind of learning should be made towards more creativity should be involved in that. More research labs should be opened in our country. So that sir, more and more, at least we get a good sound skill set of the electronics engineers. Sir, apart from that, jobs should be created and industry should be incentivized by the government to
skill
and sir.
Okay, thank you.
Bhawna, how do you look at the state of the Indian economy right now?
So Indian economy, it is the fastest growing economy in the world. Sir, after initial hit job for demonetization.
So anti-dumping, no problems?
No, sir. There are. I'm just saying that sir, the growth level is fine, but sir, with regard to job creation and the inclusiveness, there is some.
Can you identify some of the macroeconomic indicators? Then I think we can discuss.
It's a macroeconomic indicators such as inflation. Inflation is under control.
That's under control, right?
Yes, sir. Fiscal deficit is another macroeconomic indicator, sir.
Is that under control? Fiscal deficit?
Sir. Right now, it will go shoot up to 3.4%.
It is already up. We have bridged the.
Yes, sir.
We have already bridged the limit.
Yes, sir. We have bridged the limit, sir. Yes, yeah. We are not able to contain it below 3%. It is.
So probably it will, in the coming months, with the elections around the corner, it's likely to overshoot.
Yes, sir.
And what about others, other indicators?
Sir, the trade deficit is another indicator, sir. Oil prices can also be a
current account deficit.
Current account deficit is also
that has gone beyond.
Yes, sir, that is also
acceptable mark.
So it is acceptable, sir, current account.
No, it is not. It is already about 2.9% of GDP, which is very high. And that has come because of the oil price.
Oil prices.
Last year. So, any other indicator?
So, growth rate, GDP, growth rate.
Exports and imports. That again is more or less stagnating. Exports are stagnating. Latest month we have got is only about 0.5% rate of growth of exports.
Yes, sir.
So, there are crises.
Yes.
Issues.
Yes,
right? Even forex reserves, not much.
Yes, so China.
Last 1 year, I think more or less we are hovering around $400 billion.
Yes, so China is 3 trillion.
Yes. Okay, how are we doing on ease of doing business?
So our ease of doing business index, we have climbed on it. So in 2014, our ranking was 130 something, but now we are at 77 rankings.
What has contributed to this increase?
So the steps taken by Narendra Modi government has contributed a lot. So steps such as faster construction permits, faster environment clearances, GST, introduction of GST.
Anything else?
Yes, sir.
Exit option?
Yes, sir. There's insolvency bankruptcy court also. And so steps are being taken so that
which are the areas where we are still lagging behind?
So enforcement of contracts, we are lagging behind on that. And
anything else?
Another is environment clearance, land acquisitions, so it also takes some time. So, environment clearance is also stuck. Labor laws are also not flexible. So
has anything been done to improve the labor law?
Yes, so recently draft labor law was enacted by our labor minister and they were introduced. So right now they have not been passed as such. But these labor laws takes care of the labor flexibility.
One of the there are four labor codes.
Yes, so there have been wage code bill and there are...
One of them has already been in circulation and it has been introduced in the parliament.
Yes.
Okay. State of Delhi, how do you describe?
So Delhi is...
It's a state or a union territory?
So it's a union territory.
But having an assembly?
Yes, exactly.
And how is the relationship between the political head and the lieutenant governor?
So according to the mandates of High Court, lieutenant governor is the actual administrator of Delhi. But sir, there has been quite a tussle between them lately. But sir,
is there any constitutional provision which regulates this relationship?
There is a constitutional provision. There is a 239, Article 232.
Last question. From a geographer's point of view, how would you describe Delhi?
So, from geographer's point of view, Delhi is landlocked between some states, and because of that, it has become a major source of pollution. Pollution is a major problem because it is landlocked. So, other states, Mumbai and Kolkata, they
are. Anything else you would like to describe?
Yes, it is. So in terms of geography only.
Yes.
So it's a plain area.
Earthquake.
So earthquake zone. It has zone 4. It comes in very high.
Yes. Very important. Right. Thank you.
Okay. AG and state government relations are controlled by 239AA.
Yes. Right.
You said High Court had given certain judgment.
Yes.
But after this, Supreme Court has also given a judgment. Which overrides the High Court judgment.
Yes.
So, what is the Supreme Court, what verdict it has laid down?
So, Supreme Court has clearly differentiated between the responsibilities of Lieutenant Governor and the Chief Minister. So, Supreme Court has basically said that both of them has a different arenas of working and they should collaborate with each other in the proper performance of their duties. Basically, Supreme Court said that whatever the provision has been made, whatever the arrangement has been made between left governor and the CM, the powers of each of them, they said that left governor...
not touching the core of what Supreme Court has said. Supreme Court says NG is supreme in three subjects.
Yes.
But since elected government,
and it has to abide by the
wishes of
the
king. Listen to the advice of his ministers. Is there a jobless growth in India?
Sir, the it will be a little harsh to claim it as jobless.
Opposition parties say it is jobless. The NDA says no, we have created X number of jobs. What is your assessment?
So it will be a little harsh to label it as the jobless growth, sir. There are lacunas. There are some areas of improvement, sir, which can be done, sir. But labeling it as such that it is completely
jobless.
You are
beating around the bush.
Yes,
as they say, you are circling the carriage, like the Red Indians circling the carriage, but you are not attacking the problem at all. You are only circling the carriage. Come to the point.
Sir, I don't think that this is jobless.
Oh, well.
So why?
Yes. Give your arguments. 2-3 arguments that you would consider it to be a jobless goal. Difficult, huh? All right. We'll move on to something. Information technology. One of the major initiatives is Digital India program. And in Digital India program, one was to create digital highways. Second was computer literacy, right? Spreading computer. Third was connecting 2,50,000 village panchayats with internet. So let's take this last, village panchayats. What work has been done? What remains to be done?
So under the this is the Bharatnet program of the government. So under this, nearly two lakh panchayats have been made digitalized.
No, not correct.
So I don't remember the exact numbers.
What is blockchain technology, and is India using it?
So blockchain technology, it is used in making cryptocurrencies, sir. And so apart from making cryptocurrencies, it is a network security related.
Don't circle around the carriage. Come straight to the point. What does it mean? I am not asking about cryptocurrency.
So it uses the...
It stores information
in
blocks.
In a linked list. Yes, so they are connected. Yes, so they are connected.
And any change in one block is communicated to all stakeholders. Any change you make anywhere. That is... The safety part of it. Are we making use of it or not?
Sir, currently the blockchain technology is not very much in use in India.
What is 5G?
5G is the next generation of internet connectivity, sir, which India is planning to lay out in by 2000.
Why is everyone talking of 5G?
It's because of its exceptional speed and internet downloading speed and internet access speed, so it's very fast.
Only because of its speed. Now, last year the Aam Aadmi government said that they were allocating a lot of money for health and education in budget. How much did they allocate?
Actually,
are you aware of, you said something about basic education standards not to the mark. Are you aware about two initiatives taken by Delhi government in this respect for improving the reading ability and the math ability of class 3 to class 8 of students? Two major initiatives which are very successful.
In that context, sir. Sorry.
Sir. Bunyad and Chunauti. These are the two initiatives. You read.
Sir, actually, my home state is Haryana, sir. I was just born in Delhi. I've never been in Delhi, so, sir. I was not able to prepare Delhi very much in detail. I'm not speaking.
Okay, never mind. So, we close the matter here and I'll give you a little feedback. Mostly you have been able to handle the situation nicely, this interview. Most of the questioning we feel would be based on Vipadita. You write Delhi, therefore we started asking about Delhi.
So I was just born here because my mother was at my maternal aunt's home and then
we still know how I'm preparing a little on Delhi also.
The local issues are those, like you asked, the programs are not very confident.
We have given you some very good inputs. Bhawna, Chanakya,
yes.
NG's relationship and all of that. If at all, why should you cut a sorry figure? Just read it.
Yes, sir.
Your interview is more than a month away. And then Haryana, at some point you can let slip that you are brought up in Haryana, then the interviewer will change to Haryana. But since you have written Delhi, prepare a little, a few things, constitutional scheme, etc.
Yes.
Geography is another, third is information technology, we have asked you a number of questions. Fourth is your extracurricular activities, like badminton, etc. That is good. Then constitutional issues become very important. We have asked you a number of issues, constitution like Article 21, fundamental rights, significance. Significance you can use in one sentence. Fundamental rights are essential for life, for protecting life, liberty, and dignity of a human, of a citizen. Life, liberty, and dignity. Limits to Article 21 you haven't said, you could not. Limits are death penalty.
Yes.
Is a limit.
Yes.
Which means by due process of law, if a court reaches a decision that a person deserves death penalty,
yes,
then it is a, or limits on liberty also through law, wherever law can apply, law can put restrictions on both life and liberty. It is not an absolute right.
Yes.
So there is another is important judgments of the Supreme Court. We haven't asked you, but time is short, but you must remember some important judgments of the Supreme Court. Geography is a very important subject. And lastly, current affairs. In current affairs, I suggest you should take care of some important issues which are pending before Supreme Court, like Lokpal, NRC, and companies and counters, etc. All right.
You read newspapers, right?
Mm-hmm.
Read about Haryana also. Mm-hmm. Both Haryana and Delhi.
Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel. And press the bell icon to never miss an update.